Hi guys, in this video, we are going to look into the next level of grammar, context-free grammar. The agenda of this video starts with introduction to context-free grammar, subsequently introduction to parse tree and the process called derivation, then subsequently types of derivation and types of derivation tree, leftmost derivation, rightmost derivation. Now let us see, what is CFG? CFG is a context-free grammar. It has set of recursive rules. Rules will be repeated again and again. Any moment we see in the computer science world recursion, it's a repetition of n times until it meets the terminating condition based on generating patterns of strings. How many times the rules can be iterated and how long, these all decided based on patterns of strings. Context-free grammar can describe all languages, also many more things. So it's a superset of regular grammar. So whatever regular grammar, the power of regular grammar or whatever the regular grammar can generate, the same task could be accomplished with context-free grammar and much more higher than regular grammar. In terms of computation power, it is much more higher than regular grammar. Now, how the context-free grammar formally represented? Context-free grammar formally represented with a non-terminal produces single non-terminal on the left-hand side that produces combination of non-terminals and terminals. Right-hand side, it can derive combination of non-terminals or fully terminals or mixing non-terminals and terminals or terminals and non-terminals. The star, this cleanse star in the previous video, previous session we have seen. This is union or R operation. So this is a formal notation of context-free grammar. Let us see what are all the components of context-free grammar. Context-free grammar has set of production rules. Among all the production rules, the very first production rule starts with start symbol. Subsequent, always start symbol must be a non-terminal. In the every production rule, left-hand side, it must be a non-terminal. Right-hand side, it can be combinations of non-terminal or combination of terminals or combination of terminals and non-terminals. And set of terminal symbols. Terminal symbol means this is the symbol helps for deriving the string. Never the terminal symbol can generate. Non-terminal symbols or variables. Always the process of derivation or string generation is carried out only with the support of non-terminal symbols. This is a formal way of introduction. Just I am telling, context-free grammar has majorly four components: set of production rules, start symbol, terminal symbols, and non-terminal symbols. Let us see again. Context-free grammar can be described mathematically by five tuples. V stands for set of all non-terminals. T stands for set of all terminals. Sigma stands for set of all symbols or alphabet. A set of symbols or alphabet. P stands for set of all possible productions. S stands for starting symbol. Again, it is described like this. V is a finite set of variables. This can be said as variables, non-terminals also as well. Then sigma is a finite set of terminal symbols or alphabet. P is a set of production rules where each production rule maps a variable to a string. S is the start symbol. T is the set of terminals. Let us see with the example how the CFG is represented. There are many grammars that can do this task. Now let us see an example for CFG. Starting symbol or non-terminal or variable is S for this grammar. Terminal symbols are open bracket and close bracket. Production rules are S produces open bracket, S close bracket, S produces open bracket, close bracket. This is the grammar used to verify balanced parenthesis in an expression evaluation. We used to write like this, no, in a programming language, x is equal to a into b close bracket divided by c into d close bracket and one more close bracket. So all the opening bracket correspondingly it should have one close bracket. This balanced parenthesis is evaluated by this CFG grammar. The meaning of this grammar is balanced parenthesis verification. S produces open bracket and S followed by close bracket. S produces open bracket, close bracket. These two are termed as terminals. S is a non-terminal. Also, S is a start symbol. So the production starts with S. All the productions also starts with S. So there is no problem at all. S is represented as a starting term, starting symbol also, or starting variable also. All set of all possible variable also is represented by S in this case. Let us move to the next example. In this context, start symbol is represented as expression. Terminal symbols are arithmetic operators and parentheses, plus, minus, star, division, open bracket, close bracket. Where number is any number. Number is also a terminal here in this case. Now, production rules. Expression produces number. Our expression can produce parenthesized expression. Our expression can produce expression plus expression, or expression minus expression, or expression star expression, or expression division expression. So this is the grammar useful for representing arithmetic operations like multiplication, addition, division, and subtraction. How to find out the power of among all the arithmetic operators? Whichever we write in the bottom most representation of the grammar will take the highest precedence. This will have the highest power. Subsequently, this will have the next power, next power, next power. This is the order of precedence goes. Now, what is the process called derivation? Starting with the starting symbol or non-terminal, starting non-terminal, how to reach the derivation of the string? What is a string we are intended to generate? How to reach that string or generate the string is called generation or derivation process. This derivation or generation can be done in two different ways. Through sequence of generative steps or derivative steps, or through parse tree or derivation tree. Tree representation or sequential representation. Let us see one by one. A derivation tree or a parse tree is an ordered rooted tree that graphically represents the semantic information, a string derived from a context-free grammar. Every derivation tree or parse tree will have three major representations. One is root vertex or root node, and intermediate vertex or intermediate nodes, or leaf nodes or leaf vertex. Leaf nodes, last nodes or child nodes. There are two different approaches to draw a derivation tree. One is top-down approach, another one is bottom-up approach. Top-down approach always starts with the start symbol or root of the tree. Start symbol, yes, and it will move on to the intermediate nodes and finally to the leaf nodes. Whereas bottom-up approach starts from the leaf node and grows towards the root node, yes, or starting symbol. Yeah, in the process of derivation, finally the string which we harvest is said to be a derivation or yield of a tree. Now, before stepping into parse tree or derivation tree, let us understand what is the meaning of derivation, how the derivation steps need to be carried out. Let us consider context-free grammar, which comprises of NTPS or VTPS, non-terminal, terminals, and a production start symbol. Where non-terminal is S in this case, terminals are A and B, starting symbol is also S, and the productions what we need to consider is S produces SS or ASB or epsilon. Epsilon always depicts empty. Now, let us see. our purpose of derivation process is to generate this string. This string comprises of the symbols A followed by B followed by AA or followed by PB. These are all the symbols this string need to generate in the same order. In order to generate this string or derive this string, what are all the steps we need to carry out? Let us see. We need to start with the start symbol, capital S. Then this S can be replaced by either one of these three possibilities, 1, 2, 3. If I substitute SS, what will happen? Let us see. If I substitute ASP, what will happen? Let us see. If I substitute epsilon, what will happen? Let me consider S. S is replaced by SS. Now, what we supposed to do, this is the derivation process. We started with the start symbol and moved on the derivation process or replacement. Our objective is to generate A first. Then, subsequently, it should generate B. Subsequently, it should generate A. Now, if I substitute this first S by A, S, B followed by S. Now, still we reached the first symbol. This first symbol is obtained with this step. We need to move further. We need to derive further symbols. For that, we need to go on replacing the second occurrence of S by its derivatives. For that, I'm going to replace A by epsilon. What would happen? A, B, S, then it would become. If I substitute this S by epsilon, this term will become empty. So that A, B, S. Now we have obtained the second symbol also. We need to obtain third symbol. For that, what we supposed to do? We have again three opportunities. We can A is a terminal, we can't do anything. B is a terminal, we can't do anything. With this non-terminal, we need to reach this symbol A. For that, what we can do? Only the option is replacing this S by ASB. So that I am replacing A, S, B. Now we are succeeded with three symbols, obtaining three symbols. Now these three symbols are obtained. Now we may need to obtain ABB further. For that, what we can do? Now, next step, ABA. How to replace this by this S? This S further can be replaced by ASB only. There is no other go. If we substitute epsilon, we cannot obtain this string. We cannot derive this string. So again, it is replaced by AB. Then final B is ASB. 1 minute. We need to replace ASB, the final B. How this ASB is reached? This ASB is substituted by this production. So now, final step, if we look at, it will become after this derivation. Once again, I am writing A, B, A, S, B, B. In order to obtain the set or given string, this entire string, what we need to do is we need to replace this S by epsilon so that we can obtain the string. S produces A, B, A, B, B. We have reached, we have obtained. This is the sequence of steps we need to do in order to obtain a yield, or it is called derivation. This is possible with the sequence of substitution. Let us see. S is replaced by SS. Yes. First S is replaced by ASB. Second S is retained as such. The first S is replaced by epsilon so that we could obtain ABS. Subsequently, AB is retained. This S is replaced by ASB. However, we are replacing is based on scanning of this string. Left to right direction, we need to scan this string. With that approach, this scanning should become left to right direction. With this direction, we may need to substitute either this in each step of derivation or this suitable to this string. Every time, we need to consider one symbol at a time. we may need to obtain that symbol. That should be our target. So that now this S is replaced by ASD. Then this S is replaced by epsilon. So finally, we are going to harvest AB, AA, BB. This is called yield, or this is called derivation, string derivation. Now let us move to the parse tree. For the same derivation process, we are going to illustrate with parse tree or derivation tree. In this step, S. S is replaced by SS. Subsequently, the first S is replaced by ASB. Then first S is replaced by epsilon. Second S is replaced by ASB, ASB, epsilon. Now, how to collect a harvest from this tree? We need to collect in this direction. We need to harvest A, epsilon, B, A, epsilon, B, B, this. Harvesting should happen in this direction. So that if I write A, epsilon, B, A, epsilon, B, B. Concatenating epsilon with any symbol would not affect anything. So that I can rewrite it as A, B, A, B, B. The yield is obtained. The earlier scenario, we have derived the string with the support of derivation process or sequence of derivations or derivative steps. Here, the same string is obtained with the support of parse tree or derivation tree. Finally, the leaf nodes of the tree needs to be harvested in order to obtain a yield. That harvesting is also need to be carried out from left to right direction. This is the introduction of parse tree. Parse tree will have three major components. One is root node or root vertex, or intermediate nodes or intermediate vertex. This is also intermediate, this is also intermediate, this is also intermediate, this is also intermediate. Whereas A, epsilon, B, A, epsilon, B, B are leaf nodes. Let us move on to a terminology introduction, sentinel form and partial derivation tree. What is the meaning of partial derivation tree? Given the grammar, S produces capital AB, where S is the starting symbol, AB are non-terminals, capital A produces small AAA or epsilon, capital B produces capital B, small b or epsilon. In this case, how the partial tree? A tree which is not completed is termed as partial tree. S produces capital AB. This is example for partial tree. It is called a sentinel form. This, if a partial tree contains a root S, then it is called sentinel form. The above subtree is also in sentinel form. Any subtree which contains the root node is said to be sentinel form or partial tree. Now let us move on to types of derivation or types of parse trees. Leftmost derivation, rightmost derivation, or leftmost parse tree or rightmost parse tree. What is the meaning of leftmost derivation? A leftmost derivation is obtained by applying production to the leftmost variable. In the previous case also, what we did is every time we found the leftmost variable, we started replacing the leftmost variable. Here also, this S is replaced by ASB. Here also, this S is replaced by epsilon. Here, this S is replaced by ASB, this S is replaced by again ASB further, then this S is replaced by epsilon. Notice here, every time what is a non-terminal we are considering is available in the leftmost side, leftmost extreme. So that is why it is called leftmost derivation. Already we have discussed example for a leftmost derivation, LMD. This is called leftmost derivation. What is a non-terminal we are considering to replace in the sequence of steps is said to be derivation. In every step of derivation, if we consider leftmost non-terminal, then it becomes leftmost derivation. If we consider rightmost non-terminal, then it becomes rightmost derivation. That's it. Now, rightmost derivation. Rightmost derivation is obtained by applying production to the rightmost variable in every sequence of step. Now let us see. This is the string we may need to obtain. We need to derive this string. Or this is our yield. We need to derive this yield through the process called either derivation or the derivation tree or parse tree. This is a given grammar, CFG. This CFG, the starting symbol is A. A is replaced by A plus A or A minus A or small a. Now let us see how it is derived with the derivation tree steps. Now, root tree always must, root of the node always must have only the start symbol. So in both the case, we have start symbol. Now, there is no choice. In the first step, A is the only symbol available. There is no confusion whether we are going to do leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. In both of the step, we need to replace by AA. For example, first step we are considering A. Very first time we need to replace this A by A plus A. There is no other choice because we are going to derive this plus symbol for that AA. Now, in this case, if we consider this symbol first for the replacement, it is becoming leftmost derivation, LMD. If we try considering this symbol need to be replaced, this symbol, then it is said to be RMD, rightmost derivation. That is the only difference. Here I am trying to replace A. Then the associativity or the direction is going to become right to left. Here it is going to become left to right. Right to left of reverse order. This A is replaced by small a. Subsequently, in this node, we have only one option A. There is no other option. So that we are going to replace by A plus A. A plus A is here also one node. We can treat it as one node also. Then this A is replaced by small a. That is rightmost A. Then only one A is left out, that we are going to replace it by small a over. Whereas in this scenario, LMD scenario, leftmost derivation, A is replaced by A plus A. A is replaced by A plus A. After this replacement, leftmost variable is A plus A, leftmost is this. This is A is replaced by small a. Then only left out A is only this. Now this A is replaced by A plus A. A star A, sorry, A minus A, this is replaced by A minus A, this is minus. So this leftmost variable A is replaced by A, subsequently this variable is replaced by A. This is the difference between leftmost derivation, rightmost derivation. Let us see, a language word separated by C, word reverse. This word or W, W is a symbol. This W comprises of A comma B, the whole star. Occurrences of A and B in any combination, it can play a role. Whatever occurs before C in the form of W, that is going to become reversal order after C. That is the meaning. For this given language, L represents language. This is the CFG. CFG for the language WCWR is this. It has three production. First production, second production, third production. Our objective is to derive this string ABB, CBBA. We need to derive or obtain this string. In order to obtain or derive this string, we must start with the start symbol. But here, each and every production has the same start symbol, S. In such a situation, how to do? We need to look into the first symbol given in the string need to be obtained. The first symbol which is given is A. Naturally, we need to choose this production for the replacement because our first symbol matches with A. It doesn't match with B or C. So we need to replace S by ASB, the first step of derivation. Subsequently, we need to focus or scan the symbol V so that this S, how we can replace? Leftmost derivation only we are doing. We need to replace by BSB. Next, we have only one symbol. Here, there is no question called leftmost or rightmost. It's an interesting example. It is suitable for both leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. That is a beauty of this grammar. Now, there is only one yes. Then next symbol, what we are going to consider is B. So, naturally, we need to prefer in this substitution also this. Here, the production which we have considered is S produces ASB. Sorry, ASA. Here, the production which we have considered is S produces BSB. Here, the production which we have considered is S produces BSB. Here, the production which we have considered is S produces C, the last substitution. C is obtained in the last step. So, we are trying to focus these three symbols. While focusing these three symbols itself, we could be able to reach this all, leaving with one S. This last S, we are replacing by S produces. This is the step involved in obtaining the string. Now, next example, this is CFG. This CFG comprises, given the grammar CFG, comprises of three rules. E produces E plus E, E produces E star E, ID. Whichever the operator comes in the bottom line of the grammar has the highest precedence. Here, star has the highest precedence, plus has the least precedence. Let us see for this grammar, how this string is obtained using leftmost derivation. This the target string which we need to obtain, ID plus ID star ID, where ID is the terminal. We start with E produces E star E, first step. This is the grammar we are replacing. Subsequently, it is leftmost derivation. We need to target leftmost non-terminal, this one, so that this E is replaced by E plus E. Again, it is leftmost derivation. We need to target leftmost E. This leftmost is replaced by ID. Once if this E is replaced by ID, subsequently this E would become leftmost symbol. So, or non-terminal. We need to replace this E by ID. Finally, the last E we need to replace by ID. ID plus ID, last we are doing. This is example for leftmost derivation. For the same grammar, let us see rightmost derivation. In this, we started with E plus E. Here we may need to start with E. Here we started with E star E. Here we may need to start with E plus E. E plus E, rightmost derivation. We need to consider right extreme variable. We need to replace by E star E. Then right extreme variable, we need to replace by ID. Next right extreme variable, we need to replace by ID. Next right extreme variable, then replace by ID. This is called derivation, rightmost derivation. Now let us look at the example for derivation tree or parse tree, both for rightmost derivation, leftmost derivation. This is for leftmost derivation. This is for rightmost derivation. Finally, I wanted to conclude. In this video, we have seen introduction to context-free grammar, parse tree definition, derivation process as well derivation tree, types of derivation tree, leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation, types of construction, parse tree, bottom-up approach, top-down approach. Also, we discussed about partial derivation tree, or sentinel form. Also, we have discussed about the terminology called yield. These are all the terminologies along with the agenda we have discussed. Partial derivation tree or sentinel form. Sentinel form is having the root tree. Also, it is a partial tree. Next, we discussed with yield. The final string which we harvest from the derivation process or from the derivation tree is termed as yield. Thank you for watching.